In this video, we will learn to find the integral of x times square root of x plus 2. Let I be equal to integral of x times square root of x plus 2 with respect to x. We know, adding a constant and subtracting the same constant to an expression does not change the value of the expression, so I can be rewritten as integral of x plus 2 minus 2 times square root of x plus 2 with respect to x. The expansion of the integrand gives us I is equal to integral of x plus 2 times square root of x plus 2 minus 2 times square root of x plus 2 with respect to x. In exponent form, it can be rewritten as I is equal to integral of x plus 2 raised to the power of 3 upon 2 minus 2 times x plus 2 raised to the power of half with respect to x. Let's further simplify the integral by application of substitution method. Assume x plus 2 is equal to t. Let's find the value of differential of t. Taking differential of both sides of the above equation gives us derivative of x plus 2 with respect to x times differential of x is equal to differential of t. We know derivative of x is 1 and derivative of constant 2 is 0. So differential of x is equal to differential of t. In the integral I, let us substitute x plus 2 by our assumed value t and differential of x by differential of t. So we get I is equal to integral of t raised to the power of 3 upon 2 minus 2 times t raised to the power of half with respect to t. We know integral of t raised to the power of n is equal to t raised to the power of n plus 1 upon n plus 1. So I is equal to t raised to the power of 3 upon 2 plus 1 upon 3 upon 2 plus 1 minus 2 times t raised to the power of half plus 1 upon half plus 1 plus capital C. Capital C is the arbitrary constant of indefinite integral. Never forget to add this constant. As 3 upon 2 plus 1 is equal to 5 upon 2 and half plus 1 is equal to 3 upon 2. So I is equal to t raised to the power of 5 upon 2 upon 5 upon 2 minus 2 times t raised to the power of 3 upon 2 upon 3 upon 2 plus capital C. Further simplification of the above expression gives us I is equal to 2 times t raised to the power of 5 upon 2 upon 5 minus 4 times t raised to the power of 3 upon 2 upon 3 plus capital C. Let us substitute t in terms of x. As we had assumed t is equal to x plus 2, so I is equal to 2 times x plus 2 raised to the power of 5 upon 2 upon 5 minus 4 times x plus 2 raised to the power of 3 upon 2 upon 3 plus capital C. Thank you for being with me. I hope you like this video. Please click the like button and subscribe button. Do not forget to press the notification bell so that you get the notifications of my new videos. Share the video and do write in the comments. I am eager to listen to your thoughts. If you have any question related to the video or if you think I should make a video on any other topics in which you are interested, please write in the comments. Thank you.